myself Dr. A. R. Tripathi, associate professor mathematics applied science department, institute of technology and GIDA Gorakhpur. We are going to discuss the Laplace transform of f t by t and t f t. How to find if the any function f t when t is multiply, and how to find the Laplace transform when f t is divided by t. In this section, the objectives are evaluating the Laplace transform of any function f t multiply by t, and secondly, evaluating the Laplace transform of t f t divided by t, only f t divided by t. So, the Laplace transform of t f t. How to find the Laplace transform of t multiply by f t? Theorem is stated that Laplace transform of t f t equal to 0 to infinite t into f t e to the power minus s t dt. If it is exist, that is, the integral converges uniformly. Hence, f s is differentiable at s 0, and that f dash s 0 is equal to 0 to infinite del by del s e to the power minus s t f t dt at s equal to s 0. It means, because 0 to infinity e to the power minus s t f t is your f s, then differentiate f s with respect to s. And if we differentiate f s with respect to s at s equal to s 0, we have f dash s 0. And now, differentiate right hand side before the integration 0 to infinity, then it is converted to the inside of partial derivative of a function with respect to x, because using of the Lemery's differentiation under integral sign, the total ordinary derivative becomes converted to the partial derivative inside the integral sign by the Lemery's theorem. And then, this function is integrated with respect to s only partially. It means, e to the power minus s t f t only differentiated with respect to s, keeping t as a constant at s equal to s 0. When we differentiate this function e to the power minus s t f t with respect to x only, then it is come out to be what? It is come out to be minus t e to the power minus s t f t d. Then it is come out to be f dash s equal to minus 0 to infinity t f t e to the power minus s t d t. Therefore, t f t becomes f t. Then it is come out to be the, instead of f t, that is come out to be t f t, which is multiplied by e to the power minus s t e to the power minus s t. It means that is your f t. And then this integral converted to Laplace transform of minus t into f t. It means, this is the, you can say, if it is converted to the left side, then this can be written Laplace transform of t f t equal to minus f dash d s. Then, if we take in the repeated this time f double dash, f triple dash, f 4 dash and f n time, then we can get by integrating by part further, we can have in general Laplace transform of t to the power n f t, because in first derivative minus is operated in the left side of f dash s, and therefore, it can be written Laplace transform of t f t, it is come out to be minus f dash s, or you can say minus d by d s of f s. In same fashion, if we multiply, if we take f t square t cube t to the power n, then we see repeating this process, we get Laplace transform of t to the power n f t, that is minus minus minus, it is come out to be n time, it will be come out to be minus 1 to the power n, and n derivative of f s, it means d n over d s n of f s. Therefore, the n time power of t, if n, then t to the power n f t will becomes the minus 1 to the power n d by d s of to the power n f s. That is very general formula for n. For example, find the Laplace transform of t e to the power minus 4 t sin 3 t. T is multiply here. Then, t is multiply here, we know that f t equal to 1 by t square. Therefore, by first shifting theorem, we have f t to the power minus 3 I t. By shifting, we have 1 upon s minus 3 I to the power 2. And s plus 3 I to the power 2 upon s minus 3 I into s plus 3 I after breaking this way. Now, we can break it. The Laplace transform of previous function, it means Laplace transform of t to the power e to the power 3 I t, e to the power 3 I t can be expressed as a cos 3 t plus I sin 3 t. And this is come out to be, if we square of this function s plus 3 I, it is come out to be s square minus 9 plus 6 I s. Now, equating the real and imaginary part, we can, if we take only imaginary, then Laplace transform of t sin 3 t is come out to be, that is the imaginary part, 6 s upon s square plus 9 to the power 2. Again, applying the first shifting theorem, we have first shifting theorem is multiply e to the power minus 4 t. Then, where is s? Then it is subtracted by minus 4. Then, e to the power minus 4 t t sin 3 t, it will be come out to be s minus minus 4, it means 6 into s plus 4 upon s plus 4 to the power 2 square of s plus 4 and plus 9 to the power 2. And it is come out to be 6 into s plus 4, and breaking this factor, we will get s square plus 8 s plus 25 to the power 2 in square of s square plus 8 s plus 25. That is the Laplace transform of e to the power minus 4 t t sin 3 t. This is the basic phenomena. What is the Laplace when the function multiply by t? T means differentiation. F s is differentiated, then use the property of t f t. Okay. Laplace transform of f t by t. Now, further we want to discuss, given any function f t, if divided by t, then what will be the Laplace transform? So, in next topic, we have to find out the Laplace transform of f t by t. In same fashion, Laplace transform of f t by t, that is how to find s to infinity f s d s, provided f t by t exist for t tends to 0. This should be existence condition. For example, if you take, we know that Laplace transform of sin t, for example, if you take sin t, Laplace transform of sin t, it is well known that 1 upon s square plus 1. Now, limit t tends to 0 sin t by t, it is come out to be 1, then Laplace transform of sin t by t, that is this f s, this f s will be integrated, this f s will be integrated within s to infinity. Then s to infinity of integral of this d s upon s square plus 1, and integral of 1 upon s square plus 1, it is come out to be tan inverse 1 by s. And taking the limit s to infinity, that is come out to be, taking the limit s to infinity, that is tan inverse 1 by s. It means when Laplace sin t by t is used in Laplace transform, then Laplace transform of sin t by t, it is come out to be tan inverse 1 by s. Because of that, we have take s tends to infinity, that is tan inverse 0 and s to s. So, it is come out to be tan inverse 1 by s overall, then the f t is your sin t and t is divided. It is best example of the previous exercise. Next, determine the Laplace transform of sin square t by t. And second, in addition, evaluate the integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus t sin square t by t dt. Now, we start from first. The Laplace transform of sin square t can be evaluated using the trigonometrical property. Sin square t becomes 1 minus cos 2 t by t, and it will be separated 1 by 2 Laplace transform of 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2 Laplace transform of cos 2. That is come out to be 1 by 2 s and minus 1 by 2 into s upon s square plus 4. Compiling both factor, we will get 2 upon s into s square plus 4. That is the Laplace transform of only sin square t. Now, if t is divided sin square by sin square t, then Laplace transform of sin square t by t, that is come out to be integral s to infinity half whole integral 2 by s s square plus 4 with respect to s. Now, to integrating this function, we have to break up into the partial fraction, and using the partial fraction, this f s can be break up s to infinity 1 by 2 s minus 1 by 2 s upon s square plus 4 d s. 1 by 2 s, that is 1 by 2 log s, and if we multiply 2 again and divide 2, then 2 s upon s square plus 4 can be integrated. It is come out to be log s square plus 4 1 by 4 limit s to infinity. Now, log combining both factor, we will get 1 by 2 into log s 1 by 2 log s square upon s square plus 4, which is written here. This will both factor combining, we will get 1 by 4, which is written here, 1 by 4 log s square upon s square plus 4 limit s tending to infinity. Now, to existence of the limit, we have take the common s square from the numerator and denominator. Okay. Taking the common, then we will get only 4 s square, if we take common 1 plus 4 by s square upon 1. It means, if you take s tending to infinity, that is come out to be, this will be calculated, it limit s tending to infinity log s square upon s square plus 4, that is log 1, it is come out to be 0. And then we have solution 2. Now, find out the integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus t sin square t by t. It means, in the previous function, we have to multiply e to the power minus t. It means, whatever the Laplace transform of sin square t by t, if multiply e to the power minus t, then using the shifting property. Sin square, we know in our problem, Laplace transform of sin square t by t, that is come out to be e to the power 0, e to the power minus s t sin square t by t from limit 0 to infinity of dt. Thus, if you take s equal to 1, it is e to the power minus t sin square t dt. Comparing basic definition, then we will get, putting s equal to 1 in the previous problem, 1 by 4 log s square plus s square plus 4 by s square, that is come out to be, putting s equal to 1, that is come out 1 by 4 log 5. Sin square t by t, because we have calculated in previous problem sin square t by t, it is come out to be 1 by 4 log s square plus 4 by s square, and we have to evaluate this integral. When it is multiplied by e to the power minus t, then it can be written like this way, it is t multiply, and this come out to be this. Now, basic definition is your what? Basic definition is your 0 to infinity e to the power minus f t dt. F t dt, it means Laplace transform of f t is given this, and putting s equal to 1, then if you put s equal to 1, it is come out to be this integral. And the Laplace transform of sin square t by t is this, therefore, putting s equal to 1, we will get 1 by 4 log 5, that is the Laplace transform of this function, sorry, this function. Next, some assignment regarding this both topics t f t and f t by t. Number 1, e to the power t cos t, that is very simple, shifting property we can do. F t equal to t when t lies between 0 to 1 and 1 when t is greater than 1. We can use the basic definition of Laplace transform. We can find the Laplace transform of f t. Question number 3, t into t minus 2 e to the power minus 3 t. It can be also used for the shifting property as well as Laplace transform of t square and 2 t. Fourth, t cube minus sin hyperbolic 2 t. It can be evaluated simply using the problems. Previous problems and 05, question number 5, that is e to the power minus 2 t plus 4 e to the power t, that will be simply calculated regarding this exercise. Thank you.